Sometimes it's very necessary for the app to play video, whether you are creating a video player app or just a simple app. Suppose you are creating an app like YouTube where it is necessary to play videos. So, videos are everywhere and we have to learn to implement it as a Flutter developer. Don't worry, it's very simple. So, let's get started. There are few plugins available to make developer life easy. The Video Player plugin is one of the best plugins available for Flutter, which we can play video with the help of this plugin. Before using the Video Player plugin, we should add it to our pubspec file. So I open the pubspec file. Now here, Video Player plugin should be added under the dependencies block like this. If you are using VS Code, when you save the file, it will download the plugin automatically. If not, open the terminal and write Flutter pubget to download the plugin. Now, it's time to display video. We have two ways to display the video. The first way is from the assets, and the second way is using URL. In the first step, I want to display the video from assets. To do this, first I create a folder called assets at the root level of the project, and then create another folder called video inside it. Now here, I add the video we want to display. Then in pubspec file and under the assets section, specify the file path like this. In the next step, I create a new Dart file named Video Player. Now, inside this file, I define a stateful class named Video Player Widget. In this class, we are going to display the video. So, the first thing we have to do is import the Video Player package. Then, I define an instance of the Video Player Controller class. Video Player Controller should define with the let keyword because we are still not defined Video Player Controller in that line, and we are going to do that later inside the init state. Now here in the init state method, we have to initialize the Video Player Controller. As I said, I want to display the video from assets. So I use the assets method and then set the video path like this. And finally, we have to initialize the controller using initialize, and then we play the video using the controller and the play method. Now we can move on UI. Inside the build method, first I return a scaffold and then set a simple app bar. Then I use the center widget in the body. Now in the center, first we have to check whether the controller has been initialized or not. For this, we can use the isInitialize method. If the condition is true, we use the Video Player widget to display the video and pass controller to it. Otherwise, we just display a container. Now, if we run the app, we will see that nothing is displayed. Let's check the package document. If you pay attention to this line, we can see that after the controller is initialized, it calls setState to display the first frame. So let's call setState here and restart the app. Now we can see the video on the screen, but there is a small problem. It's not improper aspect ratio. That can be fixed by using the aspect ratio widget. The video player provides a proper aspect ratio of the video, and we can use that value to set to an aspect ratio widget. Now we can see the video with the proper aspect ratio. Now, I want to add the play and pause buttons. First, let's wrap the video player widget inside the column widget because we should place the play and pause button under the player. Inside the column after the player widget, let's add two elevated button widgets inside the row widget. Between those buttons, let's add a padding widget to keep some space. To each elevated button, I add relevant icons as children widgets. Then inside the play button on press callback, we can refer video player controller and call the play method to start playing the video. Inside the pause button, use the pause method instead of the play. Also, I want to add styling to the button to get a rounded looking button, which is usually in video players. And now we can remove the play that was added inside the initState method. As you can see, now we can play or pause the video easily. So, in the next step, I want to implement fast forward. Before implementing the fast forward, let's think about what we need. First, there should be a way to access the current video position or time and a way to set a new value. Controllers seek to method allow us to set the duration for the video. For this, first I create fast forward button inside draw. And now inside onPress, as I said, we can use the seek to method and set the duration. Here we have to access current video position. So as I said, we can access through the video player value property like this. And I plus it 1 second. This means when we click on the fast forward button, the video goes forward 1 second. You can implement other things like subtitle or progress indicator and so on. They are very simple. I don't do this because I don't want the video to be long. But as I said, they are very simple and you can do it by yourself. Well, now we can go to the play the video with URL. This is so simple. It is enough to use network instead of asset and set the URL here.